Hello everyone and welcome back. Today we shall be reviewing set number 71782, Cole's Earth Dragon Evil, and set 71783, Kai's Mech Bike Evo. And soon, even Zane's Ice Dragon Creature, which will be very cool. So first we're going to be looking at Cole's Earth Dragon first. So let's get to the unboxing now. Alright, so we have bag one, bag two, bag three, bag four, our little bag of bone pieces, and finally our instruction booklet and stickers. Now that that's out of the way, let's get building. Been completed. Now let's check out these amazing minifigures, starting off with Cole with his usual core uniform and his stone hammer or earth hammer. Next we have a exclusive character to the set. We have the Skull Scorpion, which looks pretty cool. Basically has the jaw piece of a skull of a bone scorpion. I mean, he has the same mouthpiece as a bone hunter, but the and same body piece and leg piece as a bone hunter, same hat, same face, but he actually has some spider legs and a scorpion tail for stinging his enemies. Which looks pretty cool, all on clip joints. And he has a bone sword for attacking. Now let's move on to the Earth Dragon, which looks pretty cool. I think it's a mix of multiple creatures. I think it has references to multiple creatures, like its spiked tail and its horns like a bull, which looks pretty cool. Also has some spikes on the back, kind of like a porcupine or a hedgehog. And it's interesting body shape, which looks pretty interesting. And we also have one of these awesome flags on the saddle, made up with a core mech armor piece, which looks pretty cool, and also some magma detail on the side, which looks pretty cool. The orange, black, tan, and brown color scheme, which and gold, which looks very cool and nice. And now that is the end of this of the review of Cole's Earth Dragon Evo. Now let's move on to Kai's Mech Bike Evo. So for our building materials, we have bag two, bag one, bag three, bag four, our bone bag, two giant wheels, our instruction booklet, the stickers, and now let's get to building. Build number 2 has been finished. Now let's look at our minifigures. Starting with Kai in his usual core outfit with no armor, with his sword and same face as always. Next we have Nia, also in her core outfit with her armor and sword. Next we have the Bone Hunter. It has the similar body print and build as the Bone Scorpion. But this time he has bone size. I believe that's what they're called. And a raised paper hat. Next we have the Bone King, which has the same print and design as the one from Jay's Titan Mech, which is cool. Now let's take a look at the mech bike. So the mech bike has full posability at the arm and also some new joints at the fingers, which are a new mold, and each hand can hold either left or right one can hold one of this awesome giant sword or lance, I believe. Well, the arms also have this awesome shoulder armor with some gold and red printing on the armor piece. And on the back we have a spot for some swords. And the legs are also fully posable. And the cockpit can open up and we can put our minifigure in XO. And there's also a few clips on the bottom of the mech, along with this jetpack, which looks pretty cool. I believe it's a jetpack with this awesome ninja flag on it that shows, I believe, Kai with his fire powers. And coming back to the clips, there are actually some other clips on the bike right here on the seat. And so we can just plug the mech in like so. And position the feet to be on the pedals. And boom, the mech is connected to the bike, which looks pretty awesome. We have some swords here up the front and some other swords at the front with some grill detailing and some engine detailing on the top with some gold printing and some fire or some signatures on the side. And also some blue lights on the side too. And also some little flames on the bottom, the back wheel, two big wheels. If you squint really hard in there, you can also see some other engine detail along with another blue light, which looks pretty cool. And there's also some golden engine detail on the sides here. See, which looks pretty cool. And there's also some handlebars so the mech can hold on to the bike, which looks pretty cool. And I'm gonna say that for a mech bike combo, I think they did pretty well on this. And that concludes this part of our build. And now for our final build. The amazing, the huge, the six-legged Zane's Ice Dragon creature. Now that we're done with the two other sets, let's open the last set. Zane's Ice Dragon creature. Now let's see what we got. We have bag one, bag two, bag three, bag four, bag five, bag six, bag seven, bag eight, and bag nine. And our our parts made from bone, which look very cool. And finally, our instruction booklet. It looks pretty cool. Set number 71786. Now that that's out of the way, let's get to building. Now let's take a look at this awesome set. First we have Zane in his usual core outfit with a golden katana. Next we have Pixel. She's basically the same Pixel from the Ninja Dojo Temple set. Next we have the Bone Hunter with the same horns and shoulder armor from the mech battle set. Then we have the Bone Knight, which is the exact same as the one from the Jay's Titan mech. And we have the Bone King, which is the exact same in one from the, also from the Jay's Titan mech. But now we have, I believe, a sort of spider crossbow creature, which looks pretty impressive with its legs and awesome design. And next we have a sort of, I think, shrine or gate for the Bone Army, which looks pretty cool. And finally, we have the Ice Dragon itself, which looks pretty impressive. See its head, it has some new jaw pieces for the mouth, open and close, some new horn pieces, and neck articulation, and these awesome wings, which look really cool, which can move in all sorts of ways. And also these flags that show a dragon and I believe a sword going down, which looks cool. And it also has this awesome spine design with these pieces that came out for Nexo Knights. And it appears to be a sword on the back. And unlike other dragons, this dragon actually has six legs instead of the usual four, which looks pretty impressive. And And so I believe that wraps up this review. Sorry, I couldn't make this a little longer, but I'm kind of in a rush. I hope you all enjoyed the video, and remember to like, comment, share, and subscribe. And remember, audience, I am the builder in shadows.